Namaskar. In this video, I would like to talk about success, about achieving success in both material life and also spiritual life. We have a deep desire, yearning, to become successful. Not only that, our entire biological system, our entire biochemistry is designed in such a way that it supports the movement towards success. When we make steps towards the goal, we get encouraged and stimulated by the hormonal secretions. We feel stronger, we feel happier, we feel more energetic. Likewise, when our life has become a series of failures, and when we lose the goal of life out of sight, when I don't know why do I exist, also the body system, it doesn't like it. And we feel that, I'm depressed, I have lack of energy, my health has become weak. So movement towards success is very important. Actually, many thousand years ago, the rules, the secrets of success were all set up. It is old knowledge, but nowadays people have forgotten it. Some people whom remember intuitively, they still become successful. And there are fixed set of rules, rather secrets. If you know them, if you follow them, there is absolute guarantee that you are going to be successful. There is not 1% chance that you are going to be unsuccessful. So I would like to talk about those secrets. Those secrets, for the first time the planet heard them about 7,000 years ago. At that time, the humanity was in the prehistoric era. Civilization was very primitive. At that time, there was a great personality born. His name was Sadashiva. He was so powerful, so mighty personality, full of wisdom, knowledge, energy, charisma. And he gave so many contributions to the human civilization. So the human deified him, and they start to worship him as a Lord Shiva. But there was this historic personality, and he had also extraordinary wife. She was also a lady full of wisdom. Her name was Parvati, and she knew many answers. She knew many things. But the intellectual standard of the people of that age was not up to the mark. So they could not come up with the very deep questions. So Shiva and his wife, they decided to enter into the sort of dialogues called Samvada, where Parvati would ask the questions and Shiva would answer those questions. And that it became, so those dialogues have become the foundation of the tantric culture. She asked so many questions. For example, how to achieve liberation, how to feel happy, so many. And one of the questions was, oh Lord, how can human beings be successful in this life, in this world? And then he told her, oh Devi, oh Goddess, I'm going to answer you. There are seven secrets of success. Then he spoke out a verse, a sort of poem. In ancient time, people have to make use of poetry. They have to combine the words into the verses, because human mind easily forgets the knowledge. But if it is a verse, if there is a rhythm, it is not easy to forget the rhythm. So if you memorize that verse, that at any point of life you can pull it out of your memory and you can have a complete teaching. So it is a very convenient way to pass on the knowledge, because at the time of Shiva there was no script, writing was not invented yet. So he spoke, Phalishyatiti Vishvasa Siddhir Pratama Lakshanam Dvitiyam Shadhayuktam Tritiyam Guru Pujanam Чатурта Саматабхава, Панчамендрия Ниграха, Шаштанча Прамитахара, Саптам Наева Видяте. this was the teaching. O Devi, O Goddess, there are seven secrets of success. Let me explain you. So first one, Phalishyatiti Vishvasa Siddhir Pratama Lakshanam. It means affirm, to be successful, one must arrive to a firm resolution, firm determination. I must be successful in my mission. First of all, let us understand what mission is. I must be successful in my mission. Mission is something human. At the subhuman state of the mind, we only seek for comforts. We are not governed and guided by the principle. And we are in a state of constant analysis and constant bargaining. Maybe I do this. What I will get out of it? Will I get reward or punishment? So according to that projected result, imagined result, I'm going to either get result or punishment. I decide whether I will do this or not. In that state of the mind, we do not analyze whether this activity is alone with the spiritual principles, is harmonious with my conscience or not. Is it right to do or not right? Only we analyze the result, whether I will get the punishment or I will get the reward. Just like a dog, when it is trained, you keep some piece of bread or piece of sugar, and then you say, give the voice, and then whoa, whoa, then you give the sugar. So that's the training of the animal mind. But the human mind is able to feel something deeper, something more internal. There is a conscience developed in the human mind. You feel intuitive knowledge. This is right and this is correct. This is simply right. I may suffer for what I do, but I cannot do otherwise. So to feel that internal guiding force is the very first step towards the mission. If you feel that, you can have a mission. Mission means everything you do, but not seeking for punishment or rewards. But you do it because it is the right thing to do. So this is called mission. Like there is two words in English, mercenary and missionary. Mercenary is the one who is getting paid. He's serving as a soldier, so he's getting paid regularly. When the payment is stopped, he deserts the field. But missionary is something different. Whatever comes, I'm going to persist, I'm going to continue. So the very first criteria to become successful is to have a mission and to have the determination. I must be successful in my mission. In many languages of the world, the idea is reflected. In my background is Russian. We have so many proverbs about that. Like one, you must measure seven times and cut only once. Think properly. And then you be decisive. Once you cut, you cut. You don't have a second chance. Don't think you will have a second chance. Do it decisively. I must be successful in my mission. Actually, even if you follow only this principle, you are bound to be successful. If you analyze the examples of successful people, they just pushed on and on and on and on and on. And they moved through many setbacks and failures, but their goal was fixed before them. There was no doubt about that goal. There is a road covered by some hard material, and there is a seed. And that seed is pushing through that crust. The seed doesn't think, maybe I will succeed, maybe I will not succeed. If I succeed, I will enjoy the sunlight. If I don't succeed, then I will rot. There is not this thinking. The thinking is, I must be successful, and it breaks the hard crust and comes out. So that should be our feeling. It is very difficult to arrive to that kind of feeling. But once you have arrived to that feeling, then nothing is impossible. Everything is possible. Even impossible is possible. Why? Because when the bargaining is going on, it is the function of the ego. You engage in your lower levels of the mind. They are limited and weak. At that state, you are weak. But once you decided, I will do irregardless of consequences, I will just do because it is right, then the ego moves aside and only divinity remains. And that divinity is invincible. It is not possible to defeat the divinity. Divinity is invincible. You can destroy my body, you can destroy my mind, you won't be able to be victorious over me, you won't be able to defeat me, because my victory is in my soul, is in my heart. So as long as my heart doesn't fail, I cannot fail. The failure is not in the external circumstances, failure is in the heart. Once in your heart, you allow that thought, I might not be successful. That is the failure. Then your heart has failed. Then everything has failed. Even the externally you have not failed. Maybe circumstances are conducive and somehow helping you. But the failure is there because the heart has failed. Not in the sense that physical problems is there, but there is a mental defeat. So that's first principle, not to allow this mental defeat. I am going to be victorious. There is an absolute certainty about that. You know, it is said that it is not smart if there are two armies facing each other. Bigger army and a smaller army. And the bigger army somehow encircles the smaller army, makes a complete circle, cuts all the ways to retreat. It is not wise to do, because the smaller army will realize there is only dead ahead. So let us try and fight, and let us really try and win. And they, for one soldier, they will take three soldiers of the bigger army. Not only that, they may even win, because in the mind there is a certainty. Before you encircle them, they think, run or fight, run or fight, run or fight. But once the circle is closed, they will think, fight. No alternative. Fight, die a glorious death. They will fight and they may win. This is the power of our mind, the psychology. Mind is powerful. More powerful than the body, more powerful than anything. And if the mind is infused with the spiritual power, it is an invincible weapon. Another example. One person, he was a wrestler, so wrestling. He was participating in championship wrestling successfully. And at one point he has broken his arm. Then his teams, the staff, everyone, okay, now you rest. You have done well. Unfortunately, this has happened. So overnight he was thinking, what should I do? What should I do? At first he thought, okay, there is no way. I just must surrender. But then this change happened in his mind. He thought, why should I surrender? I have come here to win, not to lose. Nothing have changed. I'm going to win. I will wrestle, even if I die. What? So what? I will be glorious. Then next day he came out with a broken arm. He wrestled and wrestled and he became a champion. Can you imagine? That divinity, that invincibility, and then finally self-respect. So this is extremely powerful secret of success. And we must cultivate it from the very childhood. We must become a missionaries in life. I have a mission. It is not a simple errand. It is not a simple task. It is nothing that, oh, doesn't matter. I may fail or I may win. It matters for me. I must always win. I must. Of course, we cannot control the result of our actions. We may do, but we may fail. But as I say, the failure is inside. And when you do, and you know that you have given your utmost effort, you invested your entire sincerity, entire energy of your mind into that, then you are internally satisfied. You know that you have not failed. You have done everything properly. So we must cultivate that. How to cultivate? First of all, you have to understand that this is the tendency of the mind. And as a tendency of the mind, it has the location in the body. Where? Here. In the heart. So I recommend you to watch one video. It's called Anahata Chakra in this channel. And I explain very thoroughly the function of the Anahata Chakra and how to improve it. One thing is truthfulness. If you are truthful, then your strength of mind will grow. And then you will have the determination in life. Another thing, we just have to train that determination. I have promised to come 6.00. Exactly minute into minute I will come. Maybe there is a scope to be late and come. And maybe it is wise, you know, to come 15 minutes later, because if I have to come in time, I have to sacrifice many things. Maybe I have to spend extra money to use the more expensive transportation. But in my mind, I cannot accept that. I must be as promised. There are three types of people. One, they never take any commitment. And of course, they are not successful. They have fear in the mind to commit anything. They have fear to promise anything. They don't like to marry, for example. They say, oh, you know, if I love you, why should we formalize our marriage? We love each other, then why this stamp in our papers? No need. Afraid to take commitment in anything in life. And without that commitment, why? You are calculating, you are bargaining. Anytime I can quit. Anytime I can quit. So you're not human that time. Subhuman. You are not employing that humanity, the strength of humanity in your heart. So it is important to make commitments. Are you coming for a retreat? Are you coming for that, you know, intense meditation program? I don't know, maybe. You know, I trust in the universe, how everything will, you know, if the universe desires, it will happen like this. What? What are you talking about? Take the commitment. Yes, I will come. I will come definitely. Then there is another kind of people. They take commitments. But when, and they keep their commitment, they keep their word. But when the time comes with difficulties, they're faced with difficulties, they feel, oh, difficulties too big. I cannot surmount them, I cannot overcome them. Difficulties are like that, and I'm like this. Not possible. So they give up. These people, of course, better than the first category. They are more successful. And then there is a third category of the people that take commitments, they meet with difficulties, they struggle, they feel, oh, difficulty is this much, and I'm such a little tiny speckle of dust. How can I overcome? So they say, then I have to grow and become bigger than the difficulty. And they grow, and they fight, and they struggle, and they overcome, they surmount. And when you surmount, you are a different person. You're a big person, you're a great person. So we must try and become that third category of the person. Take commitments and overcome. And especially in small things, like with the big things, sometimes fear is pushing us. I have taken a loan in the bank to start up the business. I know I must move. If I lose the money, then I will lead the life of misery. I have to pay this debt. So this fear motivates me. But it is not yet. It's still animal state of the mind. It's not yet that resourceful. So it is not clear with the big things whether there is this force of commitment or not. But with the small things that can easily be cancelled, it is very clear. You have the strength in your heart to say very strongly this. No scope, no gap. This, like this. And I'm going to do this. And you do it. And then your path to the victory, to the final victory, to the final success is out of many, many victories and many, many failures. You take up something and you struggle through failures. There may be failures, but you know that in the heart there is no failure. I'm moving towards my victory. And you struggle until you achieve the victory. A small one, and another one, and another one. And slowly, slowly, in yourself, you build up this conviction. I never give up. You convince yourself that I am never giving up. It is not possible that I am giving up. So once your mind is convinced that you are never giving up, you know, once you've taken the decision, even the most craziest decision, impossible decision, you know, you already achieved the success because you never give up. So we need to build that character. I have a friend. He likes to take commitments. Financial ones. I will buy that land. And he is a monk, sannyasi. And he likes to do for the mission, for the people, in the glory of his guru, in the glory of humanity. And he has no money. But he will say, I buy. And he goes and make the agreement. And he buys. Somehow. I don't know how. With the power of his heart. He mobilizes huge amounts of people around. But that, you know, conviction. When you see the leader, he says, I will lead you to the success. People will join. So this is the quality of the spiritual person. I'm going to do it and I'm going to be successful. And when other people will see the conviction that you are that much convinced, then they join and they help also. So this is the main principle of success. I must be successful in my mission. I cannot give up. I will not give up. When I started to do meditation, it was very difficult because I had different habits, not conducive for meditation. And I would start to do meditation, I would give up. Start again, give up again. 1 week practicing, 1 week not practicing. 1 week practicing, 1 week not practicing. One day I was sitting in an armchair and I was thinking, why I'm doing like that? Why I'm giving up all the time? And then something turned in my heart, in my mind. Then I thought, I will never stop doing meditation. I will do it. Even if I have to die, even if the earth will crack into halves, I will do it. I will do it twice a day. I will do it, and I will do it, and I will do it. And since then, I never missed meditation. And it became so easy, because the main portion of energy was spent in the struggle of the mind. You're thinking, avoiding, accepting, avoiding, accepting. You waste so much energy. But once you have acceptance sincerely, you don't waste energy there. Now you're planning how to do it. And then you do it. So try to adopt this strategy in every affair of life. And I see, when people are successful in meditation, they're regular, they're sincere, they're sitting long time, they're practicing really deep. When I observe their worldly life, I see they are established, family people, well-paid, professionals, everything proper. And also, if such people, established people in the society, they come to the path of meditation, they meditate, very quickly they progress, because they know the value of the success, of the principles of the success, and they apply them. They're strong people, they're matured people. So let us mature more and more through those principles. Sometimes there is a difference between determination and stubbornness. So it is very important to understand where is the determination, where is stubbornness. Is it giving up or just changing the course of your action? About that I will talk in the next video. Is the next principle of success, very, very important. It's about how to love what you do and do what you love. And also to choose the right course of action. Thank you very much. Subscribe to Meditation Steps. Like this video if you like. Be with us, support us, spread these ideas through your behavior. Inspire everyone and be successful. Namaskar.